If you've done everything you can to tune your multicopter's flight characteristics and are still looking for better performance, the SimonK Electronic Speed Controller firmware may be the way to get smoother flights with a more locked-in feel. Today I'm going to show you how to flash Turnigy Multistar ESCs with SimonK firmware. The same procedure can be used on other ATMEL-based ESCs with only minor changes. First, you'll need to get some hardware, a USBasp programmer — I bought this one for under $10 on Amazon — and an ATMEGA AVR socket flashing tool, like this one from Hobby King. Some people make their own wiring harnesses, but this tool clips right on the ATMEL chip and makes the job super simple. There's a link in the description to buy both of these items. Next, you'll need to download some software. Do a quick Google search for KK Multicopter Flash Tool. It should come up as the first search result. The website's in German, so you may have to use Google Translate to read it. Scroll down until you find the Downloads area, and download the appropriate software for your operating system. Next, you'll want to go to the Rapid ESC database and find out what the appropriate firmware is for the ESCs you're going to flash. For my 30-amp Turnigy Multistar ESCs, I will use the KDA Hex. Plug the socket programmer into the USBasp and make sure the jumper on the USBasp board is set to 5 volts. That way, your computer can provide the power to the ESC while flashing the firmware. Then, plug it into an open USB port on your computer. Install and run the KK Multicopter Flash Tool, and make the following settings. Set the programmer to USBasp. Set the controller to ATMEGA 8-based brushless ESC, plus enable bootloader. Then select the firmware for your ESC that was listed in the Rapid ESC database. With the ESC you're going to flash on a clean surface, carefully cut open the protective heat shrink. Make sure you don't cut too deep and damage any components or electrical traces. Remove the heat shrink. The main processor is keyed with a dot in one corner, and so is the programming socket. Align the dot on the programming socket with the dot on the ATMEGA chip and seat it firmly. Press the Go button in the KK Multicopter Flash software. In the event of a failure, the text will turn red. Double-check that the programming socket is seated properly and try again. Hold the programming socket on the chip until the process finishes and the readout says, "Flashing of firmware was successful." You can reheat shrink the ESCs, or I usually just replace the cover and seal the seam up with a piece of tape. That's it. Repeat the process for as many ESCs as you need.